Have you noticed anything else with congestion? Any runny nose? Any kind of sinus blockages that you can tell? Any kind of ear pressure, earaches? Have you been tearing up? Have you had any infection or anything like that that's been draining out of the eyes? Okay. Yeah. It's the cold time of year that can unfortunately happen sometimes. So. Well, why don't we get you situated in one of the exam rooms, and I'll be right in to take a look at your eyes, as well as the skin surrounding them and a couple of other things that might be causing irritation to these areas, okay? Alright, I'll see you in just a few minutes. Okay. The first thing that I'm going to do is I'm just going to clean my hands a little bit. So the first thing that I'm going to want to do is I'm going to get a little bit close, and I'm just going to touch around your ear, or your eyes, and your sinus areas, and you tell me where, if you feel pressure, or if it's uncomfortable, if it causes your eyes to tear, or if it feels like you're going to sneeze, let me know where that area is, okay? Okay, so I'm just going to... You do feel a little bit of pressure there. I can see your eyes are starting to tear just a little bit. Okay, so I'm gonna press now just a little bit above like your eyebrow. Okay. And then what about this eyebrow? Okay, so nothing. Real quick. I'm gonna feel along the sides of your face here. I want you to tilt your head back just a little bit. And a lot of the times when we have a sinus buildup that makes our eyes feel tender, it's actually a side effect of something that might be lingering in our sinuses, like a blockage. Your lymph nodes aren't draining correctly, so what I'm gonna do is just very gently press on your face here to about where your ears are, and then I'm going to try to bring some of that excessive fluid that might be built up there. I'm going to push it down to your neck, okay? Okay, you tell me if this is uncomfortable. If this is uncomfortable in any way, let me know, okay? Okay. It's a little bit right there. Down to your neck. for me? I'm just gonna slide that down. This can sometimes make your nose run as well. So again, we're gonna start your face. Just push that. Back to your cheeks. Okay. All right. And now, do you feel any pressure when I do put this on top of your eyelid? Okay. What about on this eyelid? Okay, it's not too bad. Like to do is I'm going to take just a very basic cotton swab and I want you to look away and I'm going to try to just get a sample of the fluid that's coming out of your eye, out of your tear duct. This is sometimes a little bit unpleasant, but I'll be very, very gentle. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put that in a petri dish, and over the next 3 days, we'll see whether or not it develops any type of infection or if there's any excessive bacterial growth. Because if you have an infection in your sinuses, there's a couple of different ways that we can test for it. But when it starts to come out of your eyes, we just want to make sure that it hasn't gone that far. Okay, and I'm going to do the same. If you can look over to this side here. I'm going to lift up on your eyelid a little bit, and I want to look up into the back of your eye to see if you have any kind of strain or bloodshot. Okay. Does that feel tender when I pull on it? It does a little bit. Okay. Yeah, I can see you're tearing a little. Okay. I'll do the same. Even though you're not experiencing any kind of tenderness there. And that way, we can just help circulate it very well. I'm going to do this with the help of cotton pads. It's going to be very gentle on the skin. But this will help us to bring down some of that fluid if you have it. That also kind of helps sometimes if you have congestion, a lot of the times if you have a dry stuffy nose and you can't breathe, one of the techniques that you can sometimes help to break that up is to tilt your head back and tap right here in between your eyebrows. And you don't have to do it necessarily very hard, but this tapping motion will sometimes help to break up any kind of dry fluid. So that's what I'm going to try doing on you right now, okay? Alright, and I want you to look up for me just a second if you don't mind. And that way I can see whether or not you have anything, maybe in your nasal cavity, okay? And now if I press on your nose, like right here, does this hurt at all? This might seem a little bit odd, but one of the other things that I'm going to try doing is pulling on your bottom eye a little bit, and I'm going to put a little bit of strain on your eyelashes. This might sound a little bit weird, but if it causes you to tear up, a lot of the times it can be a small irritation to trigger the discharge, okay? So we're going to go ahead and start on both eyes. I'm going to pull down just a little bit. What I'm probably going to do is I'm going to make a recommendation for the doctor to prescribe some antibiotics, something like amoxicillin, that will help bring out any kind of a bacterial infection. It does look like you have a sinus infection, and it's stopping up your airways a little bit, but it's also not allowing your eyes to discharge properly, and a lot of the discharge that you're getting is actually from the infection. We'll also give you a little bit of expectorant. Expectorant is intended to help produce more liquid in your mucus, which sounds terrible, but if it's stuck and once it gets dry, it doesn't have a way of exiting your body and it just stays there. So between the amoxicillin and expectorant, you should see a little bit more of that congestion come out. Cough frequently if you can. Give it a good hearty cough, shake that up a little bit, and see whether or not you can bring some more of that out. Then the antibiotics will clear up the rest. Alright. And if there's anything unusual that comes back from the cotton swabs, any kind of infection outside of the normal, we'll give you a call and we'll tell you the next couple of steps that you need to